Hello everyone, in this video we are going to learn how we can develop multiplayer experiments with O3, and specifically we are going to develop a prisoner's dilemma game. And as usual, we start by opening the terminal, navigating into our O3 folder and then creating a new app. So I'm gonna type cd test project here, and then O3 start app and the name. I'm gonna name this My Prisoner's Dilemma. You need to be a bit careful with the naming. If you have installed the sample apps, there is already a Prisoner's Dilemma. So you need to make sure that you don't use the same name. I'm not sure how it's called because I don't have the sample apps, so I'm just gonna call it My Prisoner's Dilemma for now. So now we have the app folder. Open and close here. Yep. And as usual, what we need to do is we need to add it to the settings.py. So again, I'm just going to copy one of my previous experiment sessions and rename it to my prisoner's dilemma. So let me copy this. And this needs to be my prisoner's dilemma, and then description. I'm just gonna write dilemma game, prisoner's dilemma game. And now what's new, because it's a multiplayer game, here we need to change the number of demo participants to 2, because otherwise when we try to start the experiment with one player, we are gonna get an error, because it's obviously not possible to play a prisoner's dilemma game alone. Okay. So now that we have that done, we are going to our models.py. And again, here we need to change something. We need to change the players per group to 2. So by default it's none, and none just means it's a single player game. Now it's 2. And then I'm gonna add a couple of constants here, and what I'm going to add is I'm going to add the payoffs for the participants in the different states of the prisoner's dilemma. And as you probably remember, so prisoner's dilemma game, the players have the choice to cooperate or defect, and if they both cooperate, they get a short prison time. If they both defect, they get a long prison time, and if one cooperates and one defects, then the one who defects gets free, and the one who cooperates gets a really long prison time. So we just need to choose any payoffs that reflects the structure. So I'm gonna have payoff both cooperate, and I'm gonna set this to -1, so 1 year in prison. Then we have payoff both defect, and I'm gonna set this to -3. Oops. So I'm using negative numbers here because obviously being in prison is negative. And then we have the situation where it's they make different choices, and this is gonna be the payoff for the one who defects in this case, and the one who defects gets out free. And then we have the same payoff different and cooperate. And the one who cooperates in this case gets a long prison sentence. Okay. So now we have our constants set up. So the next thing we need to do is we need to go to the player class, and we need to define a model field for defecting, or for the choice whether the participant defects or not. And there are a couple of ways that we could do this. So we could make a string field in which we just store the text defect or cooperate, and then later on we can check whether the text in the field is defect or cooperate. But I'm actually going to use a Boolean field because that's going to make it our life a little bit easier later on. And I'm gonna call it has defected. So this is gonna be true if the player has defected and false otherwise. So it's models.boolean field. And we're gonna have choices again. So and these choices are going to be, it's gonna be true if the player defects. So if you remember from our real effort task, so we type choices here, then the subject is gonna get a drop down menu where they can choose between different options. And if we just want the subjects to be displayed the same thing as stored in the database, for example, if we want to store true in the database and we are fine with the subjects seeing true in their drop down menu, then we could just type true and false in here. Actually, we wouldn't need this. We wouldn't need this curly brackets in this case. But we don't want that. We want them to see cooperate or defect. So to do this inside this list in choices, we put another list, and the first item is always what is stored in the database, and the second one is what the subject sees. So here we're gonna store true, and since the field is called has defected, we're gonna store true if the subject defects, and we're gonna store false if the subject cooperates. Okay, and then after that, we also want a label. So we want label equals. So if you remember, this is what is displayed to the subjects before they, like right before the adopter menu with the choices. So I'm just going to type please choose your action. Please choose your action. Okay. So that should be all for models. Now coming to the pages. So again, we have these three pages, and I'm just gonna rename this one to decision, and then also rename the corresponding template to decision. So in Python, it's refactor rename. And so on the decision page, we need to put the form model again. So we're going to type form model is equal to be, it's going to be player, and form fields. Fields is going to be our Boolean field that we just created here in the model supply. It's going to be called has defected. And that's all that we need here. So we don't need to return any variables for the template because all the information that we need is in the model. So we are going to access the information from the constants file directly in the template. So we don't need to do anything else here. But now we need to do something that we haven't done in previous tutorials, and we need to use this wait page. If you remember in the previous tutorials, I've always deleted this. So what are wait pages? Wait pages, like the name basically says, are pages where players wait until other players in the same group are finished with previous decisions. For example, in this game, right, we're going to have a decision, and then we're going to have results. But in order to display the results, it's not enough that player one has made the decision. We need both players' decision to actually display and calculate the results. So if player one is a little bit fast on this page and makes a faster decision, they cannot directly jump to the results page because we don't yet know what we want to display to them on the results page. So we need this wait page in between. And what this does is, as soon as, let's say, player one is the faster player, so player one finishes, then she's going to go to this page and wait. And until player two finishes, then, and when player two finishes, she's also quickly gonna go to this page. Then this condition is met, right? So this function is called after all players arrive. And again, what the name suggests, as the name suggests, it's gonna run once after all players are on this page, and then they get forwarded to the results page. So So what we are going to do now, here in this function, after all players arrive, we are going to do the check of what decisions the players made, and then we're going to set their payoffs. And so this is usually you in multiplayer games, if you want to set payoffs, you always do this kind of on a wait page, because that's the point where you know you have the information from all players, because this function only runs when they're finished with their previous page. So what we're going to do here is, first of all, we need to get our players, and to do this we are going to type self dot, no, first we can create the variable players, and it's going to be equal to self dot group and get players. So this stores all our players in this group into a variable, and in this case it's going to be two players. Maybe let's change this a bit. So we want the players separately, and it's just two, because we want to separately check later on the payoff of the decision of each, and this will put them into a list. So instead of putting them into a list and then later on getting the players out of the list again, what we can do in Python, we could just directly assign player 1 and player 2 here. So that's something that Python allows you to do. If you have a list, so this is going to return us a list, but if you have a list and you already know how many items are going to be in this list, and in this case I know there are two players in the group, so it's just going to be two players, then you can directly kind of unpack the list like this, by typing the variable where you want to store the first item of the list, and then comma the variable where you want to store the second item. So this way I just have both players already. And now we are going to do a couple of ifs to see what the players did and then set their pairs accordingly. So let's start with player 1. You just type if player 1 dot has defected. And now you can see why I wanted a Boolean field earlier on. Because now by having a Boolean field here, this is automatically true or false, so I can just write if player 1 has defected, and I don't have to write if player 1 dot decision equals defect, for example, if I would have used a string field called decision instead. So if player 1 has defected, then the question is, what has player 2 done? So we're going to ask what player 2 has done, if player 2 dot has defected. So in this case, we are in the situation where both players have defected, so both of them are going to get the payoff of the situation where they have both defected. So I'm going to call it the constants, and I payoff both defect, and the same for player 2. So else here. So now we are in the situation, we are still inside this if, so in the case where this if is true, so we are in the case where player 1 has defected, but player 2 hasn't defected. So in this case, player 1 is lucky and gets the payoff, basically gets free. Let me just remember how I named this. So I named this payoff different defect. And player 2 unfortunately is unlucky and has cooperated. So player 2 is going to get the payoff where they made different decisions and he cooperated. And now we need another else here. So this else belongs to this if. So this else is the situation where player 1 has not defected. And again, we need to ask whether player 2 has defected. And if player 1 has not defected but player 2 has defected, then we are in exactly this situation, just with the payoffs changed. So I'm just going to change player 1 and player 2 here. And I mean, I'm gonna delete it and put it here to keep the order nice with always player 1 first. And so this is our third case, and finally our last case is a case where they both cooperated. So in this case their payoff is against header dot constants, and then both payoff both cooperated. And the same for player 2. Okay, that's all we kind of we need to do in the pay to supply. So we have the logic of setting the payoffs all set up. And again, on the results page here, we don't need to do anything in the Python code, because all we're going to do later on is display the payoff. And as you can remember, the payoff is stored here in a player model, and everything in the player model you can access directly on the page, so you don't actually need to do anything here. So now it's time to go to the template file, and now we need to kind of display the payoff information and may put in the form field. And we are going to display the payoff information in a table, and it's going to be a little bit of a crude table. It's not going to look very beautiful, because the main focus of this tutorial is to kind of understand how to develop multiplayer games, not how to make beautiful web pages. So we are going to use a table for this, and it's possible to get a very nice design with HTML tables. And if you want to develop your own Prisoner's Dilemma, you probably want to spend some effort on styling the table. And to do this, I would suggest you read a basic introduction into styling HTML pages with CSS. But for now, we're just going to use a very crude table. So this is to get a table in HTML, just use the table tag, and now you need to put tr for table row, and inside each tr table row you put gd, which stands for cells, a single cell. So we want to display all the four payoff options here. Okay, so we need four table cells, and I'm just gonna start with the payoff if both defect. I know we need curly brackets here. And just go back to the models.py, see. I mean, let's start with both cooperate. Both cooperate. Then here we're gonna be in the situation where one cooperated and one defected. So we are going to use. So let's say here we have the situation where we cooperated, but our competitor or our other player defected. So we are going to put this one, and then down here we are in the situation where we defected and the other one cooperated. So let's copy this and rename this to defect. And finally, the last payoff is the one where we both defected. Okay. So now we just have a quick table that shows all the payoffs. Like I said, so this is not very clear. Ideally, you would also want to display kind of which payoff refers to which decision. But this is a bit outside of the scope of this tutorial. So the only thing that is left to do is put the form field We just can just type form fields because we only have one. And next step, we can go to our results page. Or maybe just give this page a title. We'll go back and call it please make your decision. And then here we need to name this results. And in here we're just gonna put your payoff was, and then player.payoff. Now, so if we wanted to, we could have also made this a little bit more detailed. So we could have kind of here in the pages.py decided to again get the decision that the other player made and return it here, and then we could have made something here like your choice was to cooperate, your opponent's choice was to defect, so this is why you get the payoff X. But for now, let's just keep it simple and just put the payoff here. And now we should be done, and we can go back to our terminal and start a development server and see if this works. So I'm gonna type O3 dev server. Name my page. Okay. So this is an error message, and as you can see, error messages in O3 are quite explicit. So it says name error, my page is not defined, and that occurs because maybe you've already caught this, that I forgot this, but I renamed the decision, the my page, the decision here and here, but I forgot to change it in the page sequence. So that's why I got this error here. So let's try again. Now we don't get any errors, and we can go to our browser and see if everything works. Okay. Let's start with two of this, but I can already see there's an issue here. Okay. Another issue. So now let's go back. So we can also learn a little bit about error messages in this tutorial, which is good because while you develop, you are definitely going to see an error message at some point. So it complains here that I've tried to call an invalid variable called form fields that it doesn't know, and the reason for this is because form field doesn't belong in double curly brackets. It belongs into a curly bracket and then percent sign. So right now it's going to look in, with these double curly brackets, it's going to look into my vars for templates and doesn't find any vars for template that I return that is called form fields. So this is the issue. And as you can see, O3's error messages are very nice. It kind of highlights you in red where exactly in your code the error comes from. So let's just change this. And as you can see, now it's also yellow, so now PyCharm also recognized that this is something that exists in O3. As you can see, like kind of all the words with like predefined, or the code with predefined meanings, like the table and the text here is highlighted in yellow. So if something that should be like a standard function doesn't show up highlighted, then this is already a sign that you might have made a mistake. But let's see now. Yeah, now we can refresh and now it works. And as you can see here, our payoffs, and it's kind of not very nice. We don't have borders around the cells. It's all like very tiny. So if you don't like this design, check out a CSS tutorial. But for now, I'm just going to defect with this player. And with this player, just for simplicity, I'm also going to defect, so we both should get a payoff of -3. And that's exactly what we get. So everything works now. Okay, that was how you develop a prisoner's dilemma. And see you in the next tutorial.